Education has been given top priority, I mean, for the last 15 years. And there has been large investment in terms of education, reforming education, either at K-12 or at higher education. And all of this investment was put in because everybody knows that in order to sustain the present economic situation, in order to sustain the prosperity which the society live in, you need qualified people who will be able to protect and take that in the future. So that's where all this investment and attention was given to the education system. And that's why we have the Education City, and as I said, we have also other colleges like the North Atlantic, the Qatar Community College, beside the reform plan at Qatar University. I think the most major reform plan done in this country in a way which has not been done anywhere was the K-12 reform plan. So all of this is for one objective. How can we train our future generation to be able to take the lead, control their destination, and lead the country to more prosperous time? K-12 was the major initiative taken by Qatar, or by, I would say, by any other countries, where the whole education system was changed from a centralized system to decentralized system, and where it's given a lot of emphasis and room for creativity, critical thinking, problem solving, and that's still going. But as we all know, reforming education system is really hard. It needs a lot of patience, it needs a lot of time, because when you change an education system, you are changing a society as well. Because there is no other industry in the world where society and economy is so involved in it as education system, because it's touch everybody's life. Either you are a parent or a student or a relative of someone or a teachers or administrator. So it gets into everybody's life. And that's why reforming this sector is the most difficult initiative in anywhere in the world. And Qatar is no exception in that. Qatar is a fast growing country. And in terms of education, higher education, or even school education, there is so many opportunities for business, for investment. The country needs all type of contribution in terms of teacher training, doing research, coming and working in Qatar. I mean, Qatar now and Qatar University and other universities in Qatar now are blessed with so many resources in terms of research. So faculty all over the world who really have the desire or the interest to come to this part of the world to do research, they will find there is enough funding for that research, and they really can contribute to their own career and also to the University of Qatar. So I think in terms of education, Qatar is really the land of opportunities for anyone who is interested to make a difference or a change in education. I think, as everyone knows, research is very important in higher education. Actually, the most top-ranked elite university in the world are mainly research universities. Qatar is a small country with good economic resources, has started in putting emphasis and priority on research. And they started what we call the National Research Fund, which has actually created so much activities in research at Qatar University and other universities in the country. And because research is also what we are trying to do here at Qatar University in particular, that how can we link research and make it relevant to the society, to the economy. So although there is, I would not say that we will compete in terms of research with the best research center in the world in terms of biomedical, in terms of medicine, in terms of, but we can do a lot in terms of researching issues which are related to us in environment, in social sciences, in society, in all of these aspects. So what we are trying to do here is to how to make research relevant to the country and to our own needs and issues.